So not dancers, not turn, turn, not one, two, three, four, but turn, turn, hup, hup. So it's less actually about your back and more about your arms. Hup. And I keep doing this, guys, I apologize. Buh, foot, right away. Buh, ta, yes, yes. And I know it's hard, but sometimes the idea of making a shape is the worst thing to do. However, it is exactly how you train as classical dancer. This is something that I address in our school because there's a big difference between how you're trained as classical dancer. Let's face it, everything is about positioning, right? Everything is making the positions. As you progress, you start to learn that a real dancer is, you know, moving through those positions. It's movement, it's not stopping. So it's not stop, it's crush. You know, it's like I said, you're there for like a split second before you're letting go. But there's a lot of things, like here, not stop, but turn, shut, duck, duck. Let's see the ladies once more. And then we're going to move on to something else. still, let your torsos go, breathe. When I watch some of you dance, I feel like your idea of moving your center across the floor is achieved only by your arms and legs. And I know you're thinking, well, how else in the world would you get over there if you didn't use your arms or legs? But it's a different sort of idea. What I mean is you can, it's almost like, remember when I said, can you slide your foot with your hip? You actually can. It's just initiating movement from a different place. I almost feel like some of you should think that the center of your body goes through space. Some of you only think that I'm stepping my foot forward, so I'm gonna move forward. No, push yourself. Yeah. But even in ballet, traveling, you know, the stage yesterday was actually pretty wide. Didn't have a lot of depth, but it was pretty wide. And I was like, yesterday, to some of you, in my head, travel! I was like, please, but even here. Because like the leg, holding the leg up, if you let it go, it's gonna go where it needs to go, if you just let it go. Because like I said, that rubber band. So the dynamics, if you keep everything very contained, right? Because if it's more dynamic pushing through space, then the next things almost just happen. You know, instead of like manipulation, it becomes the weight is here. You understand? So it's just, again, it doesn't matter if it's contemporary or ballet. Change the idea that it's about stepping. It needs to be about moving to center. Can we try let's try it. And then we're gonna move on. Ladies and men. Ready? And? I'm sorry. So, one thing you'll hear me talk about is keeping integrity of the original intention. As a director in a company, this is something that I have to deal with all the time. Remember the choreographer that I talked about coming in and he's got 3 weeks? So day one, he's setting some choreography, right? Setting choreography sometimes with the dancers. By day 15, 17, it looks different. The original intent is gone. That makes sense. So here, 1, 2, 3, 4. There's no anything. You're just a la seconde, dead front, and going into that. Yeah. Here we go. Yes, good. Got that. So going back to the beginning of my time with you today when we were at the bar, just remember some of these concepts. Some of them were very specific about technique, right, or technique of hands. Actually, when you think about something, I'm coming in here today and talking to you about hands. I'm not talking to you about rotation, about your knees, about your feet. Oh, I did a little bit. But that's a good thing. I'm being very, very specific, but remember that. And remember this idea of traveling, pushing, and dynamic. This is better. So, we're going to move on. Shake that out, get a drink of water. So, the first thing I want to tell you in this process is there is nothing that is wrong. And if I come to you and say, you know, let's reshape that moment, let's do something a little bit different. In my company, what I always want my dancers to understand is if you're getting feedback, interestingly, in classical ballet, sometimes when people give you feedback, I feel like it's interpreted as something negative. I don't know why dancers feel that way. Oh my gosh, they're having to correct me. Well, I mean, that's what I'm paid for. Right? Right? So it's a good thing. So right from the beginning, there's nothing that will be wrong. Good. So what we're going to do is I'm going to give you a word, and I want you to come up with a pedestrian movement. Translate, a movement a human being would do that doesn't know about ballet. Brush your teeth, dancing. Brush your teeth. Good, brush your teeth. Okay, all right, that's what I'm talking about. You know, it'll be stuff like that. So I don't expect you to be like, you know, it's not about that. I want you to really do it. So straight up.